podcasting, listening to your iPod, to lectures over and over, or your iTouch. People love this. It strikes at their heart. They can listen wherever they want. It's what's convenient for them. They're all smiles about this, right? Well, let's take a look at podcasting. Take a look at the possibilities for teaching and learning through podcasting. So many ideas are out there today. What is a podcast? Well, a podcast is a digital media file that's distributed over the internet that can be played on any of these devices, right? Students might use them to keep up with the class. Instructors might use them to advertise the class. You can save key course info and it can be replayed over and over, or bring in new information in the news that's available in a podcast. Students might create podcasts for lectures so they can listen to them. They might listen to podcasts of conferences. There's many ways or reasons in which students can embed a podcast and get excited about podcasts within a classroom setting, right? They might, in fact, summarize key points to each other. They might interview someone in the real world. They might get oral histories, right? They might discuss current events in the news. They might get language training on the web. They might have supplemental materials for their books. Language training might include Arabic or Japanese or Spanish pod, French and French pod, Italian and Italian pod, Chinese and Chinese pod, or Mandarin, I should say. 300,000 people are in Chinese pod every month alone, downloading free podcasts at the beginner, intermediate, and advanced level. And of course, we have English pods, so we can learn English in the real world. So we listen on our desktops, we listen on our laptops, we listen on our iPhones or iPods, or you name it, iTouches. It's convenient. It's flexible. It's the way people want to learn today, mobile. So you might record lectures that students can listen to later. You might have students generate their own podcasts, right? You might evaluate and use podcasts that exist out there, but determine what's available in your job setting. Talk to your instructional consulting office. Look at what's available on the web from places like NPR. Take a look at the software that's available, Audacity for the PC, GarageBand for the Macintosh, and start recording live classes or record some content for online classes. But just tinker a bit. Try things out for a minute or two and just see if you like it. For me, I'm excited about podcasts. It's easy to do. One of the easiest things I've ever found to do with technology, in fact, if you've got support. Audio can add a layer for learning. It can add to video, it can add to books, it can add to PowerPoints. You can go back and replay that audio. And if you add video to it, if you've got a camera that can come in for that podcast series, you got a vodcast, right? And if you go in and record things with your little recording devices, right? You can put this into your computer in the side and record through your USB port. Or if you've got a little recording device like so, you can create your own podcasts or podcast series, if you will, right? Many ways to create podcasts and vodcasts. But we should be aware of all these ways and take a look at what's available in podcasts and vodcasts from the business world, or, you know, nursing world or the education world. Most professional disciplines out there have hundreds of podcasts your students can listen to, in fact. And you can subscribe to them. Some of the best things out there might be available as a RSS feed if you really like a podcast show. As I mentioned in one of the other programs, Michigan School of Dentistry has everything in a podcast. Wonderful. Of course, I'm not so sure I want my dentist trained only by podcast. I'm sure they're not. It's Michigan. Kelly School of Business, IU Kelly School of Business, advertises. It recruits people through podcast means. Vanderbilt puts a number of their courses in iTunes, as do hundreds of universities around the country and around the world. There's the Michigan interface in iTunes for those podcasts. Indiana University Kelly School, I mentioned, and Vanderbilt in VUcast. But it's not just them in iTunes or in VUcast. We're talking about 250,000 free lectures, videos, films of all sorts in iTunes. You know, audiobooks and language lessons and films and so forth from hundreds and hundreds, in fact, 600 active universities. Stanford, Yale, MIT, Oxford, and Berkeley. We're not talking you know, just anybody here. We're talking some pretty high profile universities. And not only that, the Museum of Modern Art, MoMA, the New York Public Library, the Public Radio International, and PBS stations. I mean, nonprofits have much content available to use, as well as, you know, K-12 schools, universities, and even some corporate settings. Jeff LeBeau at EdTech Talk will get you involved in podcasts and interested in it. In fact, there's a website from Stanford that has 100 of the best free podcasts from colleges. Skip the tuition and just listen to these, I guess. And with the cost of college today, maybe you might. My advice is to keep it short and snappy. 3 minutes long, 4 or 5 minutes, no more than 10, 15 minutes long. And if you can bring an expert in to engage your students, somebody different, and interact with them in a podcast, great. But, you know, look at the equipment out there. Think about getting a microphone for your iPod to record things. Now, think about posting your podcasted lectures for your students to listen to, or put them in the course management system that you're using, or the learning management system. Have a script, but not too scripted. Include some humor or exchanges and some interactivities, right? Q&A back and forth, but somewhat informal, friendly, conversational. And if you record things, make sure that the URL, the web link, is not such a long, humongous thing that no one can, in the right mind, can type it in. Make it somewhat simple, or at least include a link on the website from your own homepage or from your learning management system. So be prepared, but don't overly script. And find a quiet place, peaceful and relaxing place, to test the system out, and then listen to the results. Evaluate. Relax. Relax, don't slow down, and don't rush through these things. Let students reflect a bit. Suggest resources, too, that students might go beyond your podcast. Connect the podcast to books and PowerPoints and other portals. Maybe associate your PowerPoints with it. If you want more info, try Podcasting in Plain English. Watch that video on YouTube from Lee Lefevre at Common Craft, like millions of people around the world have done. When you do the podcast, keep that microphone fairly close to you so you can, you know, get good audio. And then talk to people in your teaching and learning center, in your instructional consulting office, about best practices for podcasting, about what works and what doesn't work. Take some trainings that, if they're available on your campus or in other places. Oftentimes, there's a webinar on the internet that's free. Oftentimes, your university or college or institution or organization might have done a podcast series and made them available. Think about your profession. If it's a medical profession, heart beating and breathing and sounds might be popular for a podcast. If it's in music, the musical acoustic site from the University of New South Wales will show you how instruments sound as they get older. So it depends on the discipline what you're going to use. If you look at these portals, rich portals like Podcast Alley, that indexes podcasts, look for these directories like PBS Portal website or Podcast Alley, or the EPN Network, the Education Podcast Network, which has free podcasts in elementary, middle, and high school, college, in science, math, art, visual arts, computers, you name it, they're there. Podcast.com, what a simple name to remember. There are podcast directories in all disciplines, all content areas. Nursing, gosh, you'll find hundreds of them. Medicine, hundreds more. Find some of the best ones out there in business. Wall Street, technology. Find those websites for business, education, medicine, law, you name it. It's out there. Social work, sociology. There'll be something in, like I said, every area. We have a Teach with Tech podcast brought to you by Chris Essex at Indiana University. Take a look at instructional consulting at Indiana. But test things out. See what works. See what's good about podcasting and try them out. Share your podcast with your colleagues. Get feedback from them. But try something simple. I will say that it's one of the things that I look forward to. I love podcasting. It's very, very simple, fun to do, quick. You just jump in and do one, and it's available for your students anywhere they might be around the world. Not everyone will listen to them. That's okay. Not everybody has to, but it may be time for you to do a podcast show. Podcast uses and applications. Curt Bonk here at Indiana, coming to you. Peace. Hey, enjoy your podcast shows. Thank you very much.